Why, hello internet. Yes, I'm James and I love making things. In a recent video, we converted a goped petrol scooter into battery power. Yes, we made it with new motors, new battery systems and controllers and electrics and everything, and got it working absolutely amazing. If you want to watch that, you can click at the end of the video to see it. It's one of the funnest things I've ever built. But today, we've got something a little bit more practical. Yes, we have a petrol lawnmower made by Weibang. Yes, Weibang is a commercial brand of lawnmower here in the United Kingdom. It is amazing. Absolutely love them. It's one of my favourite rotary mower brands available. Yes, big statement. Really like them. Highly recommended. But it's got a petrol engine on it. And Weibang don't actually make battery mowers. So what are we going to do in this video? Oh yes, we're going to convert it to ego power. Can we do that? Is it possible? I don't know. We're going to find out. Because I bang, you bang, we all bang together. Let's crack on. Shoot. Uh-oh. Right. What do we need to do first? We need to unbolt a load of things we don't need and yeet them out of the way, because engine, don't need that. Choke, don't need that. Throttle, don't need that. Let's strip it down. It takes me back to my farming days, lambing this does. Got my hand up one end and round the other ear. Makes me wonder what I'm doing. Right. Oh, engine out, simple as that. I have a feeling it's gonna be a bit harder to get the rest back in again. So we have a shell of a lawnmower. We gotta put a motor into it. Let's go and find a motor. Bam, right, here is an ego motor. Yes, it is out of an ego lawnmower, so that should work. That should be exactly what we need. Cool, right. Bam, fitted. Ego battery charger. Now, you don't need to put a battery charger on a mower, but you do need somewhere to house the controls and everything, the brain of the operation, which is going in there. And the nice thing about the ego charger is the battery fits on it. Boom, like so, and then we have our battery. Cool, converted. We now have an ego-powered lawnmower. No, not quite. Now I need to work out how that's all gonna work together. We've got to obviously put controls at the top that control it down here so that we know what's going on and make sure the blade goes the right way. I've got to program all that and work out all that from a motor controller. Right, let's scratch my head and then have a build montage. Boom, let's go. Making progress. The problem I had was that the motor is just gonna fall through because that hole's bigger than what this is, obvious. So I need to make a cradle. The motor needs to be closer to the grass, otherwise we're not gonna really cut much grass. We're just gonna top it off. We wanna cut the grass properly. So now the motor goes in there, which is nicely out of the way. It gives us more space on the top as well. Yeah, move on, next stage, let's go. Fitted and the blade fitted. Yes, it's now time to do the exciting bit, the computer boxy brain system. Oh yeah, let's do it! No time to talk. You've got a long way ahead. You better hear what I say and take a walk. You're good with the best I've seen. Already took the shots with me. Give us a thumbs up and subscribe when you get a chance. Thank you very much. Yes, we have now got the first part of our housing fitted in. We'll get all the fandangle bits done here next. And then that will go on the top there, battery slot in. I think that looks a lot better. I have gone for the fast charger, had an old one of these lying around instead of the standard charger, just because I think it looks a lot more streamlined, you know what I mean? It's looking fam-dabby-dozy, I'm loving it. Let's do some soldering and like put some controller sort of thing in there and, well, yeah, just, it's all very exciting. Let's just do that. No time to talk. This is a final warning. I'm just saying I'm not playing. Take a walk. No time to talk. You've got a long way ahead. Go take a walk. Right, we have actually got a working mower. Yes, we have a battery, we have a motor controller, we have a motor, and we've now got a switch at the top end of the handlebars where it should be. But it's all a bit messy at the moment. Oh, and I've got the blade underneath. Yes, I put the blade on, so that is just exciting. Right, so press the button. We should be able to make blade speed, make blade revolutions. Lost for words. Right, ready, let's go. Nothing. That is the blade going round on a Weibang mower powered by a battery, an Ego battery. Yeah! Love it. Right. That's just crazy. Right, so I'm happy. That is good. We've now got to make that look a lot tidier. And I need to put a motor on the back axle so that we can make it drive, you know, go forward. We don't want to push a mower, do we? No, we've got to make it go forward by itself. Let's go and do that. Let's do it. Let's go. So I have some great news. Yes, the back axle is now powered by a motor. Yes, it doesn't have a belt going to the crankshaft like on a petrol mower. I've now mounted a proper motor on the back. I know, it's well exciting. I'm really, really pleased with it. I've had like three different attempts at making a bracket and a plate for it to all sit on there, but it's worked and what we've got on there is good. I've briefly just rigged it up to a motor controller just to see if we can get it to work. And I got the little switch here. So now we're gonna see it go round. Press the little switch and all being well. Yes, it goes round. I know, how exciting. Who knew I could achieve such a thing? That has a chainsaw motor on there. Now it's time to put everything together, get it all wired up nice and pretty, hopefully take this mower out and mow some grass. I'm gonna do that. It's just gonna be a couple of seconds for you because here we are. Let's go out and go on the lawn. Let's go. So the Wego e-bang is complete. We just hope it's not gonna be a Wego bang because it's my electronics in there. It's been a great project. It's been really, really good fun. You've seen the whole process in this one video. As you see, inside that controller, I have fitted a lot of electrical bits. There's a lot of electrical bits in there. It's all the controllers to control the blade motor and to control the back axle motor, which is, well, it is more than I thought it was gonna be, but I'm really, really pleased. We've also, up here, we have a beautiful, beautiful little dial, which is the speed control. Yes, you can make it go faster or slower on the drive speed, really like that. And then up here, I've made a switch, so now the original handles work the mower. Yes, like a proper mower, it still feels exactly as it should. None of these fancy buttons like electric mowers. This is still feels just like a petrol machine, but is electrified. We're gonna cut some grass, we're gonna pick up some grass here now, and then we're gonna do some mulching, and then we're gonna do some side discharging. Well, that's if it lasts that long. Let's crack on and do some mowing and see if it's any good. Right, so we're gonna set the height not quite on its lowest setting, and you know, down too low. I don't want to push the mower too much. Do one stripe, we'll probably go down in a minute. Here we go, we pull back this handle and the blades engage. I turn this dial here, and that turns on the drive, and then you press in the original drive, and we're off. We are cutting grass. No, we definitely need to go lower, right. We are gonna go lower. How low? There. There she goes again. Yeah, so that feels about the right height. Oh, I've got to do straight lines again. The drive's a little noisier than I'd want it to be, but the way I've set it up, I think I'm pretty pleased with it. It is cutting grass, and it's picking it up because it's not leaving any behind. a little bit coming out the side. Probably need a, you know, make a bit of an adjustment on the guard. I'm not really concentrating on my straight lines. I'll use that as an excuse. There's a full 7.5 amp hour battery in this, by the way. It's quite interesting to see how long the 7.5 amp hour lasts. This is amazing. I love it. It's a bit faster, I think. Yeah, all right, it's a little bit whiny, but still, I could cope with that. Everyone says the battery mower's too quiet. This is a breeze. And it still feels like a petrol mower. Still got the same controls. What I don't like about some battery mowers, they try to be different. People don't like change, do they, you know? This is great. Wonder how long it's going to be until I got a full grass box. Who knew we could actually make something that works properly? Hey, who knew? It actually looks really cool as well. Really cool. Oh, I think I might have got a full grass box, you know. Wow, that grass box is absolutely jam-packed. Look at it. You cannot ask for a fuller grass box than that. That's amazing. It is packed, absolutely packed. So that's one grass box full. Let's see how much charge we've got left in the battery. And it's still full. And that's running the blade motor and the chainsaw motor that is on the gearbox. Brilliant. Right, let's put the mulch plug in and see how good it is at mulching. This is brilliant. I cannot believe how good that is. I hope you can see that well enough on camera of how good that cut is. Right, let's mulch. Still works. And we're off. And we're mulching. Here we are. It's the perfect weather for mulching. It's 3-inch grass and I'm taking an inch off. Perfect, perfect. Yeah, it's doing a good job. I feel the deck getting full of grass. Collecting grass, tick. Mulching, tick. Let's try some longer grass with the side discharge chute on and see how far it shoots out the side, or even if it does. I don't know. Let's go in the paddocks. Let's find the goats and do that. Right, side chute on. Now it's time to shoot some grass out the side, if it will. Engine going. Engine? Who's got an engine? Right, drive. And we're off. Oh, no, not that fast, James, not that fast. It's doing it. It's cutting grass. Now I've got my speed control sorted out. Really thick. Stinging nails, all sorts. Look at it. It's just chomping through it. Oh yeah, it's chomping through it. It's chucking it out the side. Not having to collect it. Look at the cut. Weibang and Ego, I've sown the seed. Please make some babies of your own. The UK is screaming out for Ego-powered Weibang mowers. We need them, please. Look, I've proved it works. It's a proven concept. I don't mind sharing the royalties. Absolutely fine, not a problem at all. Please do it. Please, please, please. Right, more mowing. More mowing, James. Come on. Right, so the battery has died. We have done nearly all of our demo garden, bar a little bit. I'm really surprised. Obviously, I had a little bit out in the goat's field. So I think if we hadn't done the bit in the goat's field, I reckon we'd have got this whole lawn cut on one charge, which would have been amazing. You know, that Ego-powered Weibang. It's lithium-ion batteried Ego-powered Weibang. Yes, I've designed all the electronics and everything in it to work with the Ego chainsaw motor and the Ego lawnmower motor, but it works. The concept is proven. I love it. It's my favorite project we have done yet. And if you like these sort of projects, we've done other ones. We built an Ego-powered scooter. We built a petrol-powered trike. Well, five-wheel trike, actually. We've got some great cool stuff on our channel, so please check out the rest of it. Please subscribe. And we've got lots more coming, so stay tuned. We'll see you in the next one. Have a good day. Cheerio. Click up here for the scooter, or click up here to have a look at these Weibang mowers. They're pretty cool.